Priyanka Sinha. In this video, we are going to discuss about the graphical representation of motion. Graphical representation of motion. This is very important topic of this chapter. So let's start our topic. Graphical representation of motion में हमें दो type के graph पढ़ने हैं. First one is distance or displacement time graph. Distance or displacement time graph. And second is speed or velocity time graph. We will discuss these two one by one. So let's start with distance or displacement time graph. As we know, distance and displacement both are same. Distance is just the actual length covered by a body, and displacement is the length with direction. So shortest path covered by a body is defined as displacement. So you can take either distance or displacement, but most probably in graph we will represent this by displacement. If you are taking distance time graph, then you will get speed, and if you are taking displacement time graph, then you will get velocity, because we know distance divided by time is what? Speed. And displacement divided by time is what? Velocity. That's why. So I'm just making a graph here first. Suppose this is the graph that we have. Here we are taking displacement and here time, because time is independent. That's why we have to take it on x-axis, and displacement is dependent on that. That's why we are taking it on y-axis. Time here in second, and distance or displacement we are taking here in meter. So just mark some point here. It is 0, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Here also we are taking 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 meter, 50, 60 and so on. Like this we are taking points here. This is distance or displacement, and this particular axis, which is represented as x-axis also, we are taking on that time, because time is independent. That's why suppose an object start moving. We are observing that object at 0 second. At 0 second, the object was at 0 meter. So where you have to point a mark, obviously here. At 0 second, the object is at 0 meter. So we are taking a point here. Now at 1 second, that object will move a distance of 10 meter. At 1 second, the object will move a distance of 10 meter. So you can take a point like this. Right? Okay. Now at 2 second, if it covers a distance of 20 meter, so it will be like this. Again in 3 second, if it covers a distance of 30 meter, it will be like this, and so on. I'm taking 5 points here only. So this is 4 second, 40 meter. Now at 5 second, it covers a distance of 50 meter. It seems uniform. Actually, if we join these all points, then it will make a straight line. It will make a straight line. Displacement divided by time will give you what? Velocity. So here also, if you are taking displacement and time on y and x axis respectively, then the slope that you are getting from this particular graph will provide you what? Velocity. It's very simple, because displacement divided by time is what? Velocity. That's why. So this is displacement, this is time. So if you divide these two, the slope which we are actually plotting here will give you what? Velocity. This is a straight line, which is defined as slope also. This line can be represented or defined as what? Slope. This slope is now velocity. Why? Because you are taking here displacement and here time. So this particular slope is straight here. You can say this is velocity, obviously, but at the same time you can say this also. This velocity is what? Uniform, because you are getting a straight line here. So this is a graph which we are drawing here by using displacement and time, and here we are getting a slope. That slope is a straight line which will represent you the uniform velocity, because in uniform, when a body travels with uniform velocity, then always you will get a straight slope. I'm making one more graph here to represent non-uniform velocity. obviously if you are finding velocity here, so on y-axis you have to take what? Displacement. And on x-axis you have to take time. Time in second and displacement in meter here we are taking again. So just take 1 second, 2 second, 3, 4, 5, and here 10 meter, 20 meter, 30 meter, 40 and 50 meter. Now again we will plot here. Suppose at 0 second the object is at 0 meter, so the point will be here. Now at 1 second object moves a distance of 10 meter. At 1 second object moves a distance of what? 10 meter. So you will plot it like this only, right? Now okay, now at 2 second the object covers a distance of 30 meter. In next 1 second the object is traveling a distance of what? 30 meter. In first second it is covering a distance of what? 10 meter. And in next 1 second, means to say at 2 second, the object will be at 30 meter. So the point will be here. Now in next 1 second, 2 second tak to pahunch chuka hai wo. In next 1 second, object covers a distance of 20 meter. So the point will be here. In next 1 second, matlab at 4th second, the object covers a distance of 40 meter suppose. So it will be like this. Now I'm just joining these all points. So you have to join it like this, right? Now so you are not finding here a straight path. So you can say by observing this slope only, this particular object which is in motion is not traveling with uniform velocity. So what we will explain about this particular slope, this object is moving with non uniform velocity, because this slope is not a straight line. That's why you can say this particular graph or this particular slope is defined as what? Non uniform velocity. This is for uniform velocity when you are getting a straight slope here. This is for non uniform velocity when you are getting a zigzag path. So this is kind of zigzag path. That's why we can represent or we can define this as non uniform velocity. Got it? So this is the graph which we drawn here. By using distance or displacement time, here we are taking displacement, here we are taking time, and when we plot a points by taking time and displacement simultaneously, then we will get a slope here. This slope will always represent you what? Velocity. If this slope is straight line, we will say this object is moving with uniform velocity. If the slope is not straight, like zigzag path you are getting, then we will say the object is moving with non-uniform velocity. So I think this particular graph is clear. Now I'm just making a rough diagram for this. Ye uniform tha. To represent uniform velocity, we can make it like this also. Only you need to mention here what you are taking. This is displacement, this is time, then obviously this particular slope will provide you what? Velocity. Now this is straight line, so you can say this is what? Uniform velocity. Okay, and to represent this particular graph also, you can make it simple like this. It can be represented as either like this, or if you want to make it like this, then also it will be okay. This is to represent if this is displacement and this is time, then obviously the slope will provide you what? Velocity. But here the path is not straight, so we will say it is what? Non-uniform velocity. So to represent uniform velocity, you can make it like this. To represent non-uniform velocity, you can make it like this. But obviously you have to take displacement on y-axis and time on x-axis. Okay, now we have one more type of graph for displacement and time that we are making here. Again, this is time and this is what? Displacement. I'm taking 0 second here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 second, because time is in second we are taking here, displacement is in meter, so it is 10 meter, 20 meter, and 30 meters suppose. Now you started observing an object at 0 second. At 0 second, the object was at a distance of 30 meter from you. Suppose at 0 second, the object was at a distance of 30 meter. Now after 1 second when you are observing, then also object was at a distance of 30 meter. Listen carefully, after 1 second also when you was observing that object, then it was at 30 meter only. So how can you plot that? Obviously you have to plot it like this only. The object was at 30 meter only, so it will like this. And again after 1 second, when you are at 2 second, then also the object is at a distance of 30 meter only. So you will have to plot it like this only, right? Now because the object is at 30 meter only. In 3rd second, means to say next second also, the object is at 30 meter. In next second also, the object is at 30 meter. When you will join these all points, then of course it will make a straight line like this. Now see, when you started observing at 0 second, the object was at 30 meter. In 1 second also the object was at 30 meter only, and even in 3rd and 4th second also the object was at 30 meter only. In simple word you can say the object is at rest, because the object is not changing its position. It is at 30 meter only. The object is not changing its position. As we are taking displacement and time here, so obviously this slope will provide you what? Velocity. So if the object is not changing its position at all, it is at 30 meter only in between 0 to 4 seconds. So what you will say about this graph? This graph will represent you what? Velocity obviously. But here the object is at rest. So what you can say? The velocity is equal to 0 here. So when you are plotting a graph of displacement and time, and you are making a slope like this, which is parallel to time axis or which is parallel to x axis, so you can say this velocity is equal to 0, or in simple word you can say the object is at rest. You can say this also. By observing this graph, what you can say? Either the velocity of an object is 0, and or you can say this also, the object is at rest. So dono ka matlab ek hi hai. If the object velocity is 0, then obviously the object will be in rest only, right? So this is the 3rd type of graph which we discussed here in distance and displacement time. I'm just making a simple diagram for these three to represent uniform velocity. Obviously you have to take displacement here and here time. Uniform velocity ke liye slope will be like this. Ye slope kya represent kar raha hai? This is for uniform velocity. Okay, now if your graph is like this, here we are taking displacement, here we are taking time, so this particular slope will represent you non uniform velocity. And 3rd one was here displacement and here time. If your slope is like this, which is parallel to x axis, then we will say the body is at rest or the velocity is equal to what? 0. Anything you can say? Either you can say the object is at rest because the object is not changing its position, we already discussed earlier, or if you can say the velocity is equal to what? 0. Velocity is equal to what? 0. So both will be both you can write here. Either the body is in rest or the velocity is equal to 0. So this is the graph which we discussed under distance or displacement time. Now our next topic is velocity time graph. Now we will discuss about velocity time graph. That is our 2nd type. Velocity, you can say speed also, time graph. Jaise distance or time ka graph will provide you what? Displacement or time ka graph will provide you what? Velocity. Waise hi velocity or time ka graph, when you are taking velocity time graph, then it will provide you acceleration. What it will provide you? Acceleration. Now I am making a graph here first. This time obviously time will always on x-axis, and this time we are taking here velocity, and here we are taking time. So 0 second, 1 second, 2, 3, 4, 5 seconds. Here we are taking speed here, so we have to write it like this: 10 meter per second, 20 meter per second, 30 meter per second, 40 meter per second, and so on, 50 meter per second tak liya maine. So this is velocity time graph, and when you will plot velocity time graph, then whatever slope you are getting from here, it will provide you what? Acceleration. So this is our graph. On the x-axis we are taking time, on y-axis we are taking velocity. Now we will mark some point here. Suppose when you started observing an object at 0 second, then it was at rest. That means it was traveling with a speed of 0 meter per second. So the point will be here only, right? At 0 second, the object is traveling with a speed of 0 meter per second, or in simple word, you can say it is in rest. Now in 1 second, when you started observing, 0 second pe to wo 0 meter per second pe thi. In 1 second, the object is moving. Listen, the object is at 10 meter, aisa nahi bolenge. Right now, the object is moving with a speed of 10 meter per second. Object is moving because this is velocity. This is not distance now. So, object is moving with a speed of 10 meter per second at 1 second. So, the point will be here. Now, dusre second par, the object is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. So, we need to plot it like this only. At 3rd second, when you observe, the object was moving with a speed of 30 meter per second. Listen, the object is changing its velocity here. Object is changing its velocity. At 0 second, the velocity was 0 meter per second. At 1 second, the velocity become 10 meter per second. At 2nd second, the 2nd second, the object is moving with a speed of 20 meter per second. In next 1 second, at 3rd second when you are observing, the object is moving with the speed of 30 meter per second. So, object is changing its velocity continuously but in periodic way. 10 meter per second, her time, wo apni speed kya kar rahi hai? Change kar rahi hai. So, 0 second, pe 0 meter per second chal rahi thi wo object. 1st second pe the object is moving with 10 meter per second, and so on. When we are moving to 3rd second, so the object is moving with a speed of 30 meter per second. So at 4th second when you observe, the object was moving with a speed of 40 meter per second, and simultaneously at 5th second the object was moving with a speed of 50 meter per second. So this is the points which we are getting here. If you will join these all points, I'm just making a rough diagram here. So it is not a straight line, but it's a kind of straight line. Yes. So this is velocity or time graph. Here we plotted some points. When you join it, you will get a straight line. This is velocity. This is time. Here the velocity is changing continuously and you are dividing it by time. So obviously change in velocity divided by time will always provide you what? Acceleration. So in simple, no need to learn, because if you know the definition of acceleration, so it is this only: change in velocity divided by time. So this slope which we are getting from here will provide you, this slope will provide you what? Acceleration. But here the acceleration, actually the change in velocity is constant here. Har second mein body jo hai wo apna speed kitna change kar rahi hai? Only 10 meter per second. So it is in periodic way. That's why this particular slope which is providing you the acceleration will in uniform way. So this is the slope of uniform acceleration. This is the slope of uniform acceleration. Why? Because the body is changing its velocity but in uniform way. That's why you are getting a slope which is straight line, and obviously it will represent uniform acceleration. Now we will discuss about uniform deceleration or uniform retardation here also. So let's start for uniform retardation. I'm just making a graph here. Now it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 second. This is time which is in second we are taking here. And this is velocity. So suppose 10 meter per second, 20 meter per second, 30 meter per second, and 40 meter per second. Now we are going to discuss about retardation. Retardation mein aapne speed ko reduce karna hai. So we are taking here the object is moving with some speed. Suppose when you started observing that object at 0 second, then the object was already moving with the speed of 40 meter per second. Listen carefully, when you started observing an object at 0 second, because you are starting your observation, so it starts from 0 second only, but the object was already moving with some speed. So in for this graph we are taking, you started your observation at 0 second, the object was already moving with the speed of 40 meter per second. So where we need to plot a point, obviously here at 0 second the object speed was 40 meter per second. Now the speed is reducing gradually here, but in periodic manner. 0 second pe speed kitni thi? 40 meter per second. Now in next second when you observe, the speed of an object become 30 meter per second. Yani pehle second par ab uski speed kitni ho gayi hai? 30 meter per second. And in next second, matlab dusre second par, the speed become 20 meter per second. Here the speed of an object is reducing gradually but in constant manner. स्पीड 10-10 मीटर पर सेकेंड घट रही है, यहाँ पर स्पीड वॉज इंक्रीजिंग 10-10 मीटर पर सेकेंड. सो हियर व्हेन यू स्टार्टेड ऑब्जर्वेशन एट 0 सेकेंड द स्पीड वॉज 40 मीटर पर सेकेंड, एंड इन नेक्स्ट 1 सेकेंड द स्पीड बिकम व्हाट 30 मीटर पर सेकेंड, इट इज डिक्रीजिंग हियर. नाउ इन नेक्स्ट 1 सेकेंड द स्पीड बिकम 20 मीटर पर सेकेंड, सो यू नीड टू प्लॉट इट हियर ओनली. एंड इन नेक्स्ट 1 सेकेंड मतलब एट 3rd सेकेंड व्हेन यू ऑब्जर्व, द स्पीड वॉज 10 मीटर पर सेकेंड. अभी व्हेन यू अप्लाई ब्रेक ऑन एनी ऑब्जेक्ट कार व्हीकल, देन इट नेवर स्टॉप सडनली, इट विल टेक सम टाइम टू स्टॉप इट. तो ऑब्वियसली इट विल रिड्यूस द स्पीड ग्रेजुअली ना, 100 मीटर पर सेकेंड से सडनली जीरो नहीं होगा. आफ्टर 100 इट विल बिकम 90, 80, 70, 60, 50, 40 एंड देन इट विल गोज टू जीरो. सो हियर ऑल्सो इफ यू आर अप्लाइंग ब्रेक टू स्टॉप इवन दैट ऑब्जेक्ट, देन ऑल्सो व्हेन यू स्टार्टेड योर ऑब्जर्वेशन इट वॉज moving with the speed of 40 meter per second. In next second the speed become 30 meter per second, and in next second it become 20, and then in next second it become 10 meter per second. So just join these all points. Again you are observing here, this particular line is a straight path, right na? So this is uniform, no doubt. Agar straight path hai, straight slope you are getting, so it will be uniform. But this time this is not acceleration, this is what retardation, this is what retardation. So this is the example of uniform acceleration, this is the example of uniform retardation. To represent uniform acceleration you can make a simple diagram like this also. Only you need to take here velocity and here time. This slope will provide you what? Uniform acceleration. Got it? And to represent this one, you can write it like this. This is velocity. This is time. This graph is like this. Arrow you need to put here. So this is what? Uniform. This is also uniform because we are getting straight path here, straight slope here. That's why. But this is not uniform acceleration. This is what? Uniform retardation. So this is the diagram which we are making here, this is the graph which we are making here for velocity and time. Velocity time graph will always give you acceleration. If you are taking this type of slope, if you are considering this type of slope, this will represent uniform acceleration. If you are getting this type of slope, it will represent uniform retardation. Okay, now next is to represent non-uniform acceleration. It's very obvious, if straight path represent uniform, then if it is a zigzag or curvy path, then it will be non-uniform. So you are only, you need to take here velocity and here time. If you are taking this type of slope or you are getting this type of slope, then you can say this is for non-uniform acceleration, right? And if you are getting this kind of slope like this, aisa kuch mil raha hai. So what you will represent here, it is non-uniform retardation. It is non-uniform retardation. Only you need to represent here what is in your on your x-axis and y-axis. So here we are taking velocity and we, here we are taking time. If it is velocity time graph and you are getting this kind of slope, then of course it is to represent non-uniform acceleration, and this one to represent non-uniform retardation. Now one more graph is here. I am explaining it with example. 0 second, 1 second, 2 second, 3 second, 4 second taki lete. And here 10 meter per second, 20 meter per second and 30 meter per second. This is velocity and this is time. Now at 0 second you started observing an object which was moving with a speed of 30 meter per second. Listen carefully, at 0 second the object was moving with a speed of 30 meter per second. You started your observation at 0 second, the object was moving with a speed of 30 meter per second. Jab aap start karte ho kisi bhi graph ko ya kisi bhi object ko dekhna, so this is your observation first graph, so obviously it will start from 0. So 0 second pe the object is moving with a speed of 30 meter per second, so we are plotting it like this. Now in next second when you observe, matlab after 1 second also, the object was moving with the speed of 30 meter per second only. So where we need to plot it like this. And in next 1 second also the object is moving. Listen, object is moving here because we are not taking distance here, we are taking speed here. So at 0 second the object was moving with the speed of 30 meter per second. Even at 1 second also the object is moving with the speed of 30 meter per second only. And in next second, matlab second second pe, dusre second pe when you observe, then also the object was moving with same speed, 30 meter per second. Even in third second also, the object is moving with same speed, that is 30 meter per second. So this kind of graph you will, this kind of slope you will get from here, right? Now this is the slope that we will get from here. Why? Because here the speed of an object is not changing at all. Here the speed is constant, the speed is not changing here. So speed agar constant hai, so this particular slope, obviously it is velocity, it is time, so this will represent you what? Acceleration. So abhi ye acceleration jo hai uski value kya ho jayegi? Zero. If you are representing this kind of graph for velocity and time and it is parallel to x-axis, then we will say here the value of acceleration is zero. And what about the body? Is it in rest? No, it is not in rest now. Why? Because the body is moving here continuously with the speed of what? 30 meter per second. Yes, the body is not at rest. So we will not write here the body is in rest. But because the body is moving, it is with a speed of 30 meter per second. Yes, you can say one thing. Here the speed is or velocity is what? Constant. This graph or this slope can define you two things. Either you can say, pehla kya aap bol sakte ho, the velocity is constant here because the velocity is not changing at all. Or second thing you can say, the acceleration is equal to zero. Now we will discuss why the acceleration is zero. Acceleration kya hota hai? V minus u by t. Yahi hota hai? Okay. Now just start your observation. When you started your observation, the speed was what? 30 meter per second. So you can take V U as 30 meter per second, right? Now and at the end of your observation, matlab at third second also, the object speed was what? 30 meter per second. So you have to take V also as 30 meter per second because it is not changing at all. Initial velocity is also 30. Final velocity is also 30. No matter how much time it is taking. Abhi yahan par jo hamara time hai, it is 0, 1, 2 and then it's 3 second total. Hamara time kitna hai? 3 second. So when you will put the value of these all, if the speed is not changing here, then whatever be the time, no matter, it will be 0 only. So here you will get the value of acceleration as 0. Why 0? Because the speed or velocity is not changing. So for velocity time graph, if you are observing a slope which is parallel to x-axis, we will say the acceleration is what? Zero. Or this also you can say the velocity is constant. So in velocity time graph, we observed the types of graph. Just I am making all the graphs here to revise it. This is to represent what? uniform acceleration. If this is velocity, this is time then. This is to represent what? This is what? Uniform retardation. If you are getting this kind of slope, then it is what? Non-uniform acceleration. Right? If you are observing this kind of graph, this is non-uniform retardation. And if you are getting this kind of graph like this, so what you will say? Acceleration is equal to 0 here. So these are velocity time graph which we discussed here. So we have two types of graph only. First one is distance or displacement time graph that we discussed. From distance or displacement time graph, you will always get speed or velocity. And from velocity time graph, you will always get acceleration. These two things we discussed. In examination, actually they will ask you or they will provide you some graph kind of this. And they will ask what this particular slope represents. If it is velocity time, then you will say it represents uniform acceleration. Only this type of question will come from this part. But it is very important because by using this graph only, we are going to derive the Newton's law or Newton's equation of motion. So that we will discuss in next topic. So this much is enough for this session. I'm just ending this session here only. Thank you.